standing here, I just got notification of another donation to the monument effort. I'll give an update definitely on how that's happened. To my knowledge now, this is including the online donations that have been made, including your donation today here. A lot of these donations have been $5, $10, some of them $1,000. I do not have permission to actually get the name and the entity today, but I may be able to do that for you later. But the very first donation that came in was the head of the Historical Jewish American Preservation Society. And they told me as well that they wanted to make sure that this monument went back up and make sure that it was maintained. And so I would just tell you that organically these donations begin coming in. You know, we had set up nearly 2 years ago, I guess, or probably a year and a half, we had set up an online platform to be able to receive donations for the monument. And we quickly did that in the first 2 weeks, but that platform is still there. And so, obviously, when this event happened, we just restarted that, updated the amount that we needed for it. And today, we've had over 780 just online, not the least of which is some personal card donations, I would call them, that have come in the mail or been handed to us directly. And I want to say special thanks to Representative Kim Hammer, who carried Act 1231 on the House floor, and also Representative Bob Ballinger, who the Story law firm in Fayetteville. Travis Story is the general counsel of the American History and Heritage Foundation, and their firm has done yeoman's work over the past 2 years as we've progressed. But based on just doing some recalculation with you, with the $25,000 donation that's been made here today, and with the additional that we had on top of the original amount, you're looking at somewhere around $54,000 to $55,000 just in the past few days over the holiday that's come in. And so we just want to thank everybody, and I would ask people to give you another hand.